This is The Core.
Welcome, everybody. This is The Core, your number one urban breakfast show. I was going to say something, Faye. What we were doing before, you know, the show started.
I know, right?
But yeah, then I just like stop it.
Don't
yeah,
do just that. Had to snap out of it.
Yeah, I'm Dakel and the beautiful.
And I'm Faye, like y'all know.
Now, you know, it's the number one urban breakfast show. And what we do is we talk about tropical issues and also bring to this beautiful blue seat professionals, knowledgeable guests, intellectual guests, anybody. We just make sure they dissect the topics we'll be talking about today. And Faye, you want to share with them the segment we do on the court?
Yes, guys, we have the street talk segment, we have the paper talk segment, we have the now and then segment, we have the cool key jazz segment.
We have a whole lot of segments, actually.
Yes, and we have the magnet.
And today we're talking about finance and
Finance and investment banking.
Definitely. Finance and investment banking. Yeah. So we're going to short break right now, and I'm sure you want to keep it locked with us. So don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Welcome back. This is the Paper Talk segment on The Core, your number one urban breakfast show. And this is what we do. We definitely read through the headlines making rounds all over the world and also in Nigeria. Sure. Let's start with the Punch newspaper. Abuja Airport's runway terminal buildings ready today. FAA says that. Port terminal operates loses 75 billion naira to 75 billion naira fall. Looters have more money than all tiers of government, the federal government. Seized 13 billion naira. Present evidence of ownership, Sage tells Wiki. Rivers governor asks state to pray for return of cash. Oshibajo, Ambode, Dixon, Ahmed, Autumn, CAN advocates peace at Easter. Sergeant arrested for releasing 4.1 million naira exhibit to fraudsters. Gunmen kidnap monarch in Ondo, demands 15 million naira. Man sells 6-year-old girl for 200,000 naira. And we also have release Lautex subventions provost begs Ajimobi Arepeshola. An IG orders arrest of illegal tax collectors on highway. And those are the news we have on the Punch newspaper.
Okay, guys, so move on to the Daily Sun for today. And we have police sack revenue transport agents from highway order immediate dismantling of illegal checkpoints nationwide. And looters now bury cash, federal government says no plan to abolish whistleblower policy. Ex-commissioner's daughter dies of ruptured appendicitis 18 months after UK doctors fail to detect ailment. Abuja Airport ready today, says fan. And Ikoyi Gate recovered $45 million kept by Amaechi, Wike insist. Releases document on ex-governor's sale of 4 power plants. Solicits prayers for FG to refund money. Buhari APC have failed. Balarabe Musa, sorry for that pronunciation, but I hope I got that right.
Yeah, it's all right, it's all right. Sometimes those names are really beautiful. And
it's very beautiful.
All right, let's go to complete sport right now this morning. Let's start with Manchester United 2-0 Chelsea. United blow title race wide open. Herrera gets lucky twice as United stuns Chelsea to hand Spurs hope. Conte Premier League title race is 50-50, and he takes the blame for Chelsea's defeat. Well, I was going to say something, but it's okay. It's all good. Sometimes you lose, sometimes you win. All right. Yama concedes goal number 40 in League One. That is close to the worst record of goalie in that league. Ambrose Efe targets 2018 World Cup, helps Hibernian club gain promotion. All right. Ighalo confirms injury blow. And we also have Wenger says he will not accept excuses for poor performance tonight, talking about Arsenal. And that's all we have. No, there's one more. Hazard drops huge Chelsea exit hint. Well, that's all we have on Complete Sport this morning.
All right. So you're moving on to entertainment.
Yep.
I know AY Life was held yesterday and it was top-notch lit.
I actually watched
a video when Ural was asked if she had been battered after she got out of the house.
When you say battered though, it got me thinking.
Battered by Bassett. Because you know he said he had a crush on both Ural and and Debbie Rice. But it made it clear that if he was supposed to pick one, he would definitely go for Debbie,
Debbie Rice. Yeah, you said that on our show here,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, I said that here.
So what do you mean by you got Bassett? Have you got Bassett Euro? We're asking you the same question. Faye, do you think she's got Bassett?
Nah, I totally doubt it.
Are you sure?
I kind of don't. I don't like, I'm not looking.
You don't feel.
Yeah,
but she said something about his butt, though. Like, he has
Yeah, but she said she doesn't have a thing for guys with hot butt, but it's different with Bassett.
Well, something happened yesterday.
What's that?
They beat my club 2-0.
I know.
You know.
I know.
It was really, really, you know.
I was planning to cry, though.
It's just the thing. You have to look at things from a positive light. You know, if we won them again, then life is not going to be balanced. Because we've met them like 3 times.
Are you trying?
And we just let them win. Like, all right, you guys just take it. And that's
I wish that's what happened, but that's not what happened.
It's all good. It's all right. So we go on another short break. And when we return, you get to know who the guest is on the court today. Number one Urban Record show.
Wole Oluwode Rotimi is an M&A associate at Stanbic IBTC Capital, an alumni of Ivy Business School at Western University, Ontario, Canada. Wole Oluwode Rotimi also attended York University Sulich School of Business from 2005 to 2009 and Essad Business and Law School from 2007 to 2008. His skills include financial analysis, financial modeling, corporate finance, investment banking, portfolio management, deal creation, oil and gas services, to mention a few. Mr. Oluwole Rotimi was a member of a sector coverage team responsible for originating and executing investment banking transactions in the Nigerian upstream oil and gas sector from July 2011 to May 2013. Ladies and gentlemen, Wole Oluwole Rotimi.
Talking about investments, as in we invest, as in to make profits.
Investment is an act of, should I say, investing for the future or saving for the future.
Sound is a way of you imputing your money in a business with the aim and an objective of bringing out a profit.
Understand, and to have something to hold on to in life. As in, for you to have a place where you earn a living.
You are investing to yourself. Now, there are different kinds of investment. There are investment for the future. It's still for yourself, but there are also investment for your own personal self. That is investing to yourself, either to your education, to your career, or to whatever.
So you invest your money in the sense that, and before you invest, it should be like, it should be calculated. Your calculated risk. Investing is a risk.
At number five, my top five swallow meal is, I just pick Semovita.
How did you pick? But you say you don't like swallows, but you still picked it because you will eat it till they give it to you. Guys, my top five for the first time in agreement is Semovita.
For swallow meal, I just take wheat. I like wheat.
On my top four people is wheat too.
Number one,
yes.
Top five swallow meals in Nigeria.
Mm.
Amala.
I knew it was gonna hit it.
I'm gonna fairly Amala.
Hi guys, you're welcome to Say Five on DelarueTV. My name is Fola.
And I am D to the A to the K to the E to the
To the L.
Back from that short break. Now we're going to talk about the topic and introduce our guests.
Our dapper looking guest.
Welcome.
This morning.
Yeah.
Yippee.
I'm liking the jacket and everything.
Thank you.
I'm liking your shoes too.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
I'm liking the wristwatch too.
But it was.
It's all right. Thank you.
It's a lot. Yeah. I'm out of crush.
Good. So today we're talking about finance and investment banking, Mr. Oluwole Rotimi, right?
Yes.
Yeah, you're welcome.
Thank you.
No, I did good. So today we're talking about investment banking,
sure.
Finance and investment banking.
Yeah.
When people talk about that stuff, they just feel like you're talking about money.
You know?
How much more is there to invest in?
So investing and investment banking are two different things, right? Investing is...
Thank God, that's why you're here.
Investing is, you know, you earn money, you save some of it, and then you put it into something else that will earn you more money while you're doing your job or doing other things. That's investing. Okay. Investment banking is helping companies that are in business to raise money to grow their business or do something else that they want to do. So, for example, Lagos State wants to...
Basically companies, right?
Yeah. Usually companies, governments, large institutions. Mm-hmm. So, for example, Dangote building the refinery, he would have hired investment bankers to raise him. I think he raised like $5 billion or something.
Oh. Wow. So at the end of the day, this money it doesn't come from them. It doesn't come from maybe friends or...
No, it doesn't come from friends and families. Partners. It's you know, when you're a small business, you would use money from like your savings from your friends and family. Mm-hmm. But when you're a massive company, you would use investment bankers.
How do investment bankers or bankers help generate such for these companies?
You know, where do they even get that money from?
How does it work?
The ironic thing is, part of the money comes from our own savings, right? So
how does that work?
So, for example, you put your money in a savings account or in a mutual fund account for an asset manager to manage.
Yeah.
The asset manager might decide that it's going to take part of that money and invest it in a bond that a government or whatever is.
That's with your permission, right?
No, you've given the asset manager permission already to invest the money on your behalf.
Okay.
So if, for example, Lagos State was raising $10 billion, they can't come to every single individual to raise the money. So they'll go to these big finance houses, and they have already taken all our savings that we've already given them to invest for us, and then they will invest it on our behalf.
How do you generate your savings? Mm.
Personally, my savings?
No, I mean, your savings,
from my salary.
The salary must be huge, I'm just saying. Yeah, I'm like, that must be so huge.
No, I mean, if you think about it, Lagos State has over 20 million people living in it. Right. You know, Nigeria, 180 million at last count. So there are lots of people putting in, you know, 1,000 naira, 2,000 naira.
And then that's just getting into your... And then
the thing is, you know...
It's all right.
We're actually even talking about investment banking, investment and all that. We might not even know the true definition of what investment means. So if you can break it down, you know, in your words,
what exactly does it mean to invest?
Yeah. Okay, so I would define investing as taking a little bit of money that you've earned and you putting it into another place that will earn you more money.
When you say a little bit, how big is it?
So I think in general people try to say that you shouldn't
put your life savings.
Put more than 30% of what you earn.
Which you earn.
Okay. Into any single investment.
Right.
Okay. Because you never know. Like they say, don't put all your eggs in one basket. Mm. If you put something into...
You have to spread.
And if you put it into something and it doesn't go well, or it doesn't go the way you planned, then you lose all that money. Okay. So you don't want
to... Okay, so there's really no stipulated amount as to...
No, it's just a guideline. You can decide. So if you find some people are putting money in MMM.
No, I'm just saying.
Yeah, if you have 500 naira, you can decide, you know, you want to leave it in a savings account. You know, that
investment banking will work, yeah?
No,
let's just say 30% is good.
30% right? is 30%.
So I'm sure you do more than 30%.
I'm not, why do you think I do?
I mean, it's oozing all over you. I'm probably doing like 150%.
You know the real deal. I mean, you know more than the layman would do.
I do 30%. Yeah.
No, we don't believe.
Really?
You guys believe? No, we don't believe.
I do 30%.
So let's talk about what people actually, now you've given us a definition of what it means to actually invest, you know, put your money into something. Let's talk about what people should actually invest in.
Okay.
What are we investing in? Where are we actually investing?
What are we investing?
You know.
Well, we're investing our cash, our money.
Is it cash or valuables? Because some people...
Right, so you can't invest valuables. You need to turn those valuables into cash first, and then you can invest it.
Oh. What about those people that, you know, get jewelry, gold, diamonds, and all that, and put it up somewhere, like in a vault or something?
So that's not investing, because if you put it in a vault, you're saving it, you know, it's safe, but it's not going to generate any additional value while it's in the vault.
Some sort of income or percentage when you get to save something very precious.
No, that doesn't work that way. You have to. So one of the ways to think about it is you're taking some risk, you know, and you're getting a return in exchange for that risk. So if you are taking zero risk, you're going to get zero return. So you can put your money under your mattress. It will be super safe, but you get zero return.
Now you're talking about risk. Let's just throw out that question. What are the risks involved when it comes to investment banking? Because then you said don't put your eggs in one basket. Yes, you want us to spread it, but if I'm putting about 80% in investment banking, what should I have at the back of my mind? It may not work and all that. What should I be skeptical and scared about? Because
everything has its own good havocs. Yeah.
There are many things you should worry about. But I think
now I'm scared.
The way to think about it is, you as an individual, you don't have the expertise to determine to play in the same space that investment bankers play.
Okay. Yeah.
Which is why you don't play in it, right? You leave it to people who know what they're doing, and then you put your money with, in it. For example, a mutual fund is a good way to invest your money.
What does that mean?
So a mutual fund is, is like, I don't know what the equivalent, like,
word is,
but it's a massive group of people put different amounts.
It's a glorified adjo.
100%. That's what it is. 100%.
The only difference is that you see men in suits doing it. Like,
absolutely, know. And they charge you, you know, 5% or whatever.
They charge 5%.
I don't know. I just made that
number. All right.
So apart from, what are the risks that we're looking at?
Yeah. So you know, there's a risk when someone invests your money that they might lose it. But it's very rare in Nigeria. You find usually mutual funds invest in very safe things. They invest in like government. Government can never default. They'll just print more money and pay you back.
Yeah, because I was going to ask you why an investment would fail in the first place.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Why does it fail? Why would an investment fail?
So there are certain types of investments that can fail. So for example, if you invested in shares of some companies that are on the Nigerian Stock Exchange,
and
the share price goes down, you lose all your money. You can lose all your money.
And that can be refunded to you?
No, you get zero.
You get zero. You don't even get a refund.
It's possible to get zero.
I mean, seeing people jump into the lagoon, I'm like, if that happens to another person, that's
terrible. Like, there should be, like, I feel like there should be some sort
shouldn't
of...
Shouldn't there be some sort of compensation if that happens?
Some sort of return of cash.
Because you are...
You're trying to get, like, double of what you put in. Yeah, you're also trying to help whatever corporate body you're investing in.
Yes.
So why wouldn't you even get your money back?
So you know, things can go good or bad, right? When things are good, they're really good. You get dividends, the share price is going up,
smiling,
everyone's happy. But then when things are not going so well, then you don't get any of those things, and you could actually lose your money, which is why, you know, it's advisable to get proper investment advice before deciding to put your money in a stock market or something like that.
Okay, so for you, looking at the market women, looking at entrepreneurs with small businesses, investment banking may not work for them, right? So what do you think is the appropriate way for them to invest? What is the right platform for them to? Is it just the savings account? Because when I talk about savings, what comes to my mind is you have an ATM card.
Yeah.
You can easily do the mobile
card. You can just save the money.
Yeah. So what's the best way to...
So I would think that a good way to protect your money if you have an entrepreneur is to invest in what is called a fixed income mutual fund.
What's that?
So a fixed income mutual fund is like an ajo, like we said, but they only invest.
I think at the end of the everything's just
ajo. So you know, and there are lots of companies that do this, banks, asset managers that do this, and so they take the money from all of us. We put 1,000, 1,000, 1,000. They take out 3,000 and they buy a government bond. So for example, your savings account might be paying you 4% or 2% interest. This government bonds today I think are yielding something like 13-14%.
Wow, that's a huge.
So that's a big difference that you can benefit from. I would say if you are, you're a small business owner, you shouldn't
venture into
things like stock market and all those things without getting
people want to make more money.
Or for example, I know some mutual funds that return as high as 17% because they invest in bonds of big companies. So if you invest in the government, you get 13%. If you invest in like a company, you get like 15 to 17%.
What's the span?
And it's so the mutual fund, the fixed income funds, they will tell you when you're investing that okay, you need to put it for a minimum of 3 months because if you take it before that, they may not give you any return. They'll give you back your money, but they won't give you any return.
Any amount?
They won't give you any additional.
I'm
thinking
like for you to invest.
You need to find out from the. Usually they would, as far as I know, it's between 30,000 and 50,000 naira is what you can. Okay. Is the minimum you can.
So I was gonna ask you like investment and investment banking, but you already told me there are two different things.
Because very different.
I was gonna talk about the market woman. I was gonna talk about the boy on the streets and all that. But we go on a short break right now. We've already seen the first segment of the interview. Just keep it locked for the second one. I'm telling you, talking about money. Keep it locked, guys.
We'll be right back.
This is the core.
Welcome back. It's still the core, your number one urban breakfast show, and Mr. Wole has been he's been dissecting some really financial stuff that I never knew about.
I'm going to invest in this. Yeah, I'm also curious.
I'm definitely, because at the end of the day, I told you about the 30 billion.
I told you I'm whistleblowing. I'm telling you, just so you know.
No, don't blow the whistle yet. Just yet,
brother. The whistle is out there.
Well, anyway, this is the Magnet Game Show segment. I'm sure you never saw this coming.
Did not.
Yeah, great. That's what we're doing. We're full of surprises. So Magnet Game Show is that show that say something. If I say Wole, what comes to your mind?
Me.
Great. So all you just have to do, you have 3 seconds to give me a back-to-back answer. When I say something, you just have 3 seconds. Then Faye is a beautiful time. Don't just trust me. She's going to do really. She's very gentle.
She's very kind.
Be kind.
Right? Thank you.
No way. We're never kind. So are you ready?
Okay.
All right. So 3 seconds. Don't forget. Kolo.
Risk.
Kolo.
Crazy.
Money inside bra.
Why?
Yahoo Boys.
419.
419.
Yahoo Boys.
EFCC.
Whistleblowing.
Ikoyi Apartment.
50 billion.
Dizeni.
50 billion.
New Note.
Bank.
Whistleblower.
Me.
CBN.
CBN. What's in CBN governor?
Donald Trump.
Donald Trump. Crazy man.
30 billion for the account. Point at me now.
You.
One more.
Why?
Third Mainland Bridge.
Jumping.
Stanbic IBTC.
Great bank.
Treasury account.
Savings.
Recession.
Nigeria.
Gumbody.
I don't know what that is.
Ikeja.
Here.
Jacket.
Right. Yes.
Bra.
Why do we keep going back to bra?
Just answer the question already.
Breasts.
Anyway, he did a bit of justice to
it.
It's all good. So we go on another short break. You saw me perform. It's not just a banker that.
Yes, sir. It's all cool. I just dished
you know,
out the
answer. It's not just all about the banking.
Yeah, I try.
It shows that you know you.
No, banking.
All right, guys, we go on another short break. And trust me, the second segment of the interview comes forth pretty soon. Keep it locked. Don't go anywhere.
This is the core.
So actually, if you invest your money on something, the money, the capital is still there and you still make profits. And you can still decide, maybe there may be a time you decide to say maybe you don't want to invest that money on that thing again.
Right.
You can still take your capital.
Financial investment could also be referred to either in a business.
Because there are so many shares, like in shares, buying shares is an investment. So you don't buy a share into a company that is off and on. You buy a share in a company that is stable. Now you know that when even when they are down, they are still making money. They are still doing things.
I think for one to venture into investment, you should have, you know, have a vast knowledge about it, then know what the investment will stand a chance of bringing back to you in a test of time.
Like you have an idea, a sellable one, an idea that will make you better, and you invest your money into it. Once you invest your money into it, with time, though at the scratch might be struggling, but with time, you know that with your strategy and tactics, with time, you know that you need something better.
You start flipping this out, and you flip that out, and you flip the other thing out. Ah, what's going on here? And then, first he sees the tools, and then he ends up seeing a Bob Risky. Like, what the?
I really don't get why a guy would fall in love with another guy.
I am putting on both parts. So if he touches me and then he feels it, he won't be too shocked.
Am I mad? When they are strong, tall, dark guys with body frame, and I start admiring BC for crying out loud.
Funny enough, you know, I've actually done that before.
Oh my God, so now me get this guy. I'm going to tie him like this to myself.
It's time for my top. Yeah.
Still the core, your number one urban breakfast show, and we have this man dissecting all stuff about finances to us.
And about
all
right? the human species.
Yeah. Is that
what we're dissecting?
Yeah.
You talked about stuff.
That was a setup. Oh,
that was, you know.
You kept asking about bra.
You
mentioned bra like 5 times.
No, that's not true. I just did it once.
At least 3 times.
Yeah. But it's alright. Let's move on.
Moving back to what we're talking about. So we're talking about finance and investment banking.
Yeah.
Thank you for correcting me about telling me the difference between investment and investment banking. All right. So I want to ask you another question. Right. We have government bodies. Mm. We have different bodies in the government. So why do they still venture into investment banks to actually get loans, do projects and all that? What's the correlation?
So as much money as the government has, it doesn't have all the money it needs to do everything it needs to do.
It's been a couple of years that you've been in this banking business.
Yes.
Right. So don't you think Nigeria is capable of being a very strong financial economical country?
Yeah, you know.
Don't you think? Then if you think so, then what the heck is the problem?
He's recession, but we just found it out. It's $15 million.
Well, I was actually going to talk about recession and coming to recession, talking about something. But if we have the capability, then why are we still in so much lack?
Brother, there are many problems with Nigeria, though. Like, that's like asking me why is Nigeria not the biggest.
Yes,
anything.
Yes. You know,
it's baffling.
The giant of Africa. Right?
You know, we make a lot of money, but you know, there's $50 million in someone's flat, right?
Just
so there are lots of issues that we need to deal with.
Financially.
Yeah. So
you know, like he sees the money. He knows how the money comes and goes, and he sees what is happening.
Yeah.
I don't know how it happens. I don't know what happens. So like, apart from, I'm saying financial wise now, what's the target, what's the aim, what's the problem?
So I think there isn't a problem. It's just we're in an evolution. So we're how many years old is Nigeria? And you know, it will take
one good point.
It takes the education of the population as well. So people need to become more aware of what is going on in the financial industry.
Right.
Awareness is one. And you need to participate. So if you believe Nigeria should be, you know, this massive financial hub, which it has the potential to be, you also need to stop, you know, putting your money in your bra.
We know, right?
And
you just mentioned bra. That's the sixth time we're hearing it today.
I mean, you're a man of good taste.
You've programmed it into my mind. That's the problem. So you need to start to use the formal financial sector, and when you do that, you are contributing to the growth of Nigeria as well.
How effective? You talk about investment banking. How effective is it in Nigeria?
I would say it's very effective. It's not as big an industry as, for example, New York, Wall Street, investment banking.
Right.
But part of that is a function of the economy. The economy in the US is multiple times as big as Nigeria's. So that's part of why we're a lot smaller. But in terms of the capability of Nigerian investment banks to raise money for Nigerian companies, I would say the capability is there.
Okay.
And a lot of the investment banks in Nigeria have relationships with banks and investment banks outside Nigeria. So what you find is sometimes you are raising money from Nigerians, but you're also raising money from Americans and South Africans and Europeans and so on.
Okay, so for someone who invests in or does investment banking, now what are the benefits associated with it? The profit when I invest, say, 40,000 naira, I think that's small for investment banking. No, I'm just saying.
It's not small. It's
relatively okay. This man has some billions, man. Whistleblower on the corset today.
Are you sure you're going to leave this place the same way you came?
I hope so. I feel like this is not like a threat situation.
You should be scared of me the most.
What are the benefits? You invest this particular amount as a company, as you said. Now, what are the benefits associated with it for companies who aren't doing it yet? What should they know? Okay, this and this is attached to it. So maybe we should take it on. So let's just know the benefits.
So as a company trying to raise money, what are your options really? You can go to a bank, and we all know how banks are. It's not easy getting loans from banks these days.
It's terrible. The cost
is also very high, 20%+ interest on loans.
Yeah.
What's your other option is you call all your family, friends, everyone to come and invest in your business. If they have the money, they might. If they like your business, they might, but you can't.
It takes the grace of God. Yeah.
So an investment bank helps you because in their decades and decades of working, they know a lot more people than you.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
So they have a lot of connections and contacts in Nigeria and outside Nigeria to help you raise money.
Okay.
Obviously that comes at a cost. So you pay the investment bank, you have to pay a return to the investors.
So that's how you guys get your own money too.
That's
what I'm saying. Like, it's part of how you get paid.
But that's normal. If you go to
I'm just saying.
I agree, yes.
Yeah. No, I'm just trying to clear the air here.
So you do have to pay the investment bank for the bank service.
How much are we paying?
How affordable is it to pay an investment banker? How affordable is it?
It depends on many things. It depends on the size of the company that is hiring the bank.
Okay.
And it depends. So a lot of banks will have a minimum fee that they will not go below. So if you're able to pay that, you can pay them.
Can we have a range?
No, I wouldn't be able to give you a range.
Say something. Just give us a figure.
Just give us an idea.
Look at us. Like, okay, you know what?
It's impossible for me to say. Because banks have a wide range of prices or costs for the services they provide.
Okay.
Hey!
Yes. That's more like it. That's
more like it. That's huge, man. Did you mention 100,000 there? Like that's even near 1M.
Right. No, I mean it's something.
You get a lot for that, but
yeah, sure.
Again, it depends on the bank and lots of other factors.
Right. So how accessible is this whole process? How fast is it? How accessible for someone like me that doesn't know much about the banking system? I want to do maybe I'm starting a small business. I want to do something. How can I access these people and get what I want, all the criteria, all the necessary documents? How can I get these things?
I would say the first, if you're a business and you're thinking about hiring an investment bank, yeah. The first thing you need to do is, you know, literally just walk up to an investment banker.
Wait, where do you find them? Where are they?
Just Google investment banks in Nigeria. You'll find lots of them. And there are very many. There are lots of big investment banks and there are lots of small investment banks.
Okay.
So find them, walk up to them and talk to them about what you're trying to do. Mm-hmm. And they'll give you a sense of whether what you do fits with what they provide.
Okay.
And also what it would cost you, how long it will take and so on. Because depending on what you're trying to do,
right.
Some types of transactions can be done in 3 months, some will take a year and a half. So you need to be aware of
how long you need to
get specific on what you are trying to achieve and get someone to help you do that.
Okay, great. Now let's just ask this. Yeah. Why should people invest?
You're gonna ask that in Jiffy though.
Yeah. I'm not saying maybe not just for investment banking, but even savings account and all. Why should people
invest?
Put their money into the bank? Why should they invest?
It was that short answer, like give us a fast answer.
It's very simple. You're not Superman.
Yeah.
So you should let your money work for you. So you are working, you are collecting salary, but your money too should work, and then when it creates more money, that one too should work.
Like
when I'm moving money like and money, you get one debit alerts from nowhere. Something PS transaction, $400 or something.
I like that. Yeah. Let your money work for you. I like that. We go another short break. Definitely, yeah. We're going another short break. And when we return, we have more segments coming your way. You don't want to miss it. Good luck.
Yeah, we'll be right back.
This is The Core.
Welcome back. It is the cookie jar segment on The Core. And whenever you guys...
I'm tempted to eat cookies, but it's not for us.
No, it's not for us. It's for him.
So I guess.
Yeah, he's definitely going to have a lot of cookie. I'm sure
he
will definitely have a lot of cookie.
And it's like set up number 2. We cash it.
All right, so let's just move to the cookie jar segment. All right. You want to tell him the
Yeah,
the
so basically, there are questions contained here.
All right.
You can see them. So you're going to pick one. If you can't provide an answer, you eat 2 cookies. You just throw them in your mouth. And then as you're throwing them in your mouth, you pick another one. You read it out even with the cookie in your mouth. And then, yeah, that's just how it goes.
What if I answer it, I eat the cookies.
If you answer it honestly, you don't have to eat the cookie.
Oh, honestly, okay.
Honesty is it.
Right. He wants to eat the cookies, so trust me, it's not going to be
take
on
it out. All right.
All right, so just...
All right.
Just any...
Yeah, just anyone.
Pick a random... So you read the question
such
out.
A setup.
Read it out.
Nice.
I know, setup number 2.
Really easy questions.
Have you ever been addicted to something? What? Yes, I have. So I used to be addicted to video games. No, it's serious. I lost my scholarship. I was playing games. It was pretty serious.
Oh, my goodness.
Okay, that's serious.
Yeah. Almost dropped out of school.
But we you're like a man now with plenty of dollars in your account.
You know,
so
it's not true.
Are you sure of the $50 billion, the $50 million?
It's not
dollars.
For him.
This guy, you keep mentioning $50 million. Come and search this guy.
All right, you gotta pick another one.
All right. Girl on top or you on top? It's close. I have to say girl on top.
Oh my goodness, why do you have to make that sound like...
When you say girl, what do you call the style? I can't remember the style. You remember the style?
Cowgirl.
Hey,
cowgirl. Cowgirl.
Yeah. No, give me.
You don't want to have cookies? Why you
I want the cookies, but would you slap your dad for $1 million? No, no.
It's $1 million.
No.
$1 million.
No, it's not worth that much. No.
$1 million.
Nah. You guys need harder questions in here.
Yeah. Oh, you just said it.
Happiest day of your life. Yeah, I'll eat a cookie.
Because you really don't know, right?
It's too...
You take two, mm-hmm. yeah, put two in your mouth at the same time. You munch it. So you give it to her, they pick another yeah. question.
You, as you're chewing, you just
read yeah, so yeah, I got it.
Yeah. You got it, yeah? All right.
Who's your favorite
Sorry,
person?
Say that what?
We can't hear you.
Huh?
Who is your favorite person?
Who is friend for us?
And why?
Who's your favorite person and why? All right.
My favorite person is my wife.
Why?
Because she agreed to marry me.
Aww, easy breezy, man.
Yeah. Good stuff. Fast, man. Pick it up.
Mm. Those cookies are good. What is the longest time you've gone without sex?
Yeah. Do you remember?
Wow, that's...
I mean, you're married, right?
Almost like a year.
What?
Almost a year.
Oh, that's great.
I was engaged almost and I had to go off to school, so...
Right.
Aww.
I went a year.
How did you feel?
How did you cope?
It was not easy. I
know, right?
Yeah.
But you know, we would, man.
It took a lot of.
A lot of, you know.
Yeah.
Okay.
Good stuff.
Just please, my wife is washing.
Thank you.
What was your childhood nickname? OJ. OJ. Yeah. Do you believe in love at first sight? Absolutely. I'm such a romantic. Come on, guys.
Right.
I'm just going to eat a cookie just for kicks.
Just for the fact that, you know, yeah, just whenever you eat a cookie, I'll take two. So you pick another question.
Do you want
to No, I can't eat it.
Faye, why are you going to cry?
It's tempting me to eat the cookie, but I can't eat it.
Pick another one. What read it.
Who was the last person to see you naked?
Yeah, who? Apart from your wife.
Apart from my wife?
Yes.
I'm weak.
Yes. Great stuff.
Great! Oh, it has to go in.
The investor Game bankers got some skeletons. Last question. What? All right, we gotta go on break, so you have to read that fast.
What?
What are you saying?
We're dead.
Okay.
Most expensive thing you own.
What is the most expensive
thing you
own?
I want more.
You just no.
I'm more.
Guys, you
That's
know what?
I'm more.
I can't hear you.
But I'm sorry. Yeah. We have to go on a short break, and trust me, when we talk, we have more questions coming.
This is the car.
Say she gave you cookie.
Welcome back.
Welcome back from that break.
Welcome back. Yeah. So I was looking at you eating.
You're still stuttering.
No, I'm not stuttering. I was looking at you eat a cookie with so much passion. Why?
She gave me the cookie.
She gave. Oh. Okay. We got it. So this is a now and then segment. Let me sit up straight. This is a now and then segment.
I'm
lost
still. Who gave you cookies?
You did.
I didn't give you no cookies.
They were nice too. They're like yummy cookies. They're like crumbling in your mouth.
I love the face. Okay, it's all right.
Okay. We talk about how it was back in the day and how it is right now. So now and then investment banking, was it more prominent then than it is now? What was the... Because back in the day, it feels like Kolo was the only way.
Kolo! I remember once my grandmother gave me that thing, like, just keep dropping your money. But I got so frustrated. Like, one day, I just broke it. I said, what is this for? Let me know how much is inside there. But yeah, moving on. Was it Kolo then, or had investment
based
banking?
Based on logistics. Was it...
Guy!
You know, no.
Now, the work where they do
we
now.
We have to make it what it is. You understand?
So I would say back in the... You know, investment banking and investing has become more prominent. People are becoming more educated about it.
Okay. What do you think people invested in more back in the day?
I'm not sure. I'm not that old.
Well, you know.
But if I had to guess, I would guess most people put their money in savings accounts. You know, they didn't really think about investing it.
I'd like to disagree, though, because I feel like our grandparents were more knowledgeable when it comes to investing. Because I kind of think
they invested, but maybe not through this means of investment. Maybe they invested inside their wardrobe or inside their...
But like we said, that's not investing.
You wouldn't believe, if you go back to your lineage now. Did I get it right? Lineage?
Yeah. Lineage.
It's lineage, yeah.
It's all right.
Lineage, yeah. It's all good. if you go back, right, you would see that your father's father have they have like a, they have some shares that you probably don't even know about.
Yes. Land.
Land, shares, documents and all that. That means they were actually enlightened about these things, about investment, about shares, about having, you know. So I might probably disagree with you.
So if you think about shares, in the 1960s there were maybe 20 or so listed companies on the Nigerian Stock Exchange. Today there are 180.
Wow.
So if you were going to buy shares, there are people who would have bought shares, but they would have bought shares. There wouldn't have been that many people who were buying shares. There weren't that many companies to buy shares in.
Okay.
Today, there are a lot more companies to buy shares in, and there are a lot more people buying those shares, both in Nigeria and abroad. So you have international investors coming to buy shares in Nigerian companies.
That's great.
So I would say definitely today investing is a lot more prominent and people are a lot more educated and wise about going about it.
Well, in terms of being educated and wise and all that, has an awareness been created by the investment banks and investment bankers? How much awareness has been created for people to know that there's actually
in subtle words, just tell us briefly.
Lots of people are doing a lot of work to educate people. Regulators, the Securities and Exchange Commission, the CBN, they're trying to educate more people to participate and grow their wealth.
How are they doing this? Because I don't hear of any.
Yeah, so they, unfortunately, you know, it will be in stages. So I believe right now they have programs that they do online. They have some things that they share at universities and so on. It's not as much as it could be. They need to do a lot more.
All right, thank you very much. All that thoughts, we have to go on another short break. And we've seen the Now and Then segment. Keep it locked. We still have more coming your way. It's still the core.
This is very hot, by the way, so 1, 2, 3. We are the Auburn Rulers and we bring everything to your table to keep you glued to your devices. So guys, on another episode of Fit Fam Kitchen, don't go nowhere, just keep it locked. Bye guys.
Welcome back. This is the Man Crush, Woman Crush segment and also the Versus segment. So we'll be asking you who your man crush is, the man you want to crush. Woman you're crushing on. Come on. No, I didn't mean it that way. And Versus. So who
y'all need to be checked, man.
No, I'm good. Mm-hmm. I'm good. So who's your man crush?
I think someone I look up to a lot.
You had to rephrase it, right?
Yes, I mean, 14 years is real, man. Yeah. I understand.
Yeah. Right, and he still has the 50 million he wants to spend, so I mean.
Yeah, but I think someone I look up to and I can, you know, consider a man crush is...
That's deep.
Fola Ishimoju. Fola is an investment banker that I met when I joined the bank I work with now.
Okay.
And he just epitomized everything about banking
to you, right?
Being an investment banker, I looked up to him a lot.
Mm.
I never actually worked directly with him, but I really,
he's like your mentor, right?
Okay,
he pushed you through.
My mentor.
All right,
yeah, just people that you just see, and
I just see.
So, what about your woman crush? Who's your woman crush?
I'm just gonna be honest.
Be honest, that's right. You have to be honest.
I have his crush on Angelina Jolie.
Well, I mean, you could get a chance still. She's separated right now. So, are you thinking?
I've sent her lots of emails. She's just not.
You see this expression.
I don't understand what's going on.
I felt like we
Brad
had a chemistry.
Pitt, Brad Pitt, so got in there just as things were.
Yeah, happening. I mean, you're more good looking than Brad.
That's
so,
what I thought. That's what know. I thought. But I don't know. Yeah. And she's busy like adopting babies and stuff.
You know, people say.
You really think you're like than Brad Pitt?
Yeah. What? Come, look at him. Look at his jacket. What?
Ah.
You don't blow out.
The pillow had to drop.
Yeah, I know. Like when he said that, you're like, nah, you're joking.
Said, no, I'm sorry.
No, me and Brad Pitt, we go way back.
Way back.
And, back in the day, people used to like.
You know when you have hope, eh?
You know, somebody says something like, if your dreams don't scare you, then you're not dreaming.
Keep dreaming, man. Yeah, keep dreaming.
Good stuff.
Keep dreaming, man.
Yeah.
Wow.
All right, because of that fact, we have to go to the verses.
Okay. Yeah.
So appear to
yeah.
No. Appear to ladies with you right now. Yes, you have to pick one and you have to
ditch the other one,
throw one away.
Oh, I like that.
So
he's blushing.
We have Alicia Cara and we have Ariana Grande. So who are you picking?
Alicia Cara. You know, throw away Ariana.
Why are you going to throw away like Big Sean?
Why
thrower?
Throw into like lagoon kind of throw? Not even like
why?
Why?
Just like fling.
You have a hate for her.
No, I feel like Ariana is so.
She's a baby.
She's like a. She wishes she was black.
All right.
I think.
Okay. Does she Ariana?
Yeah, I feel like. Have you listened to her album?
Yeah, she's kind of turning more into that.
She's like trying to be like Nicki Minaj or something. Mm-hmm. I don't get that. She's
trying to evolve.
She's fine, but she.
The height doesn't scare you, yeah? You're good with the height.
Alicia's like. Why would you like Alicia? That's child abuse. I think Ariana is actually older than Alicia Cara, right?
Age is just a number, bro.
Why
about
do you keep,
age? Can you get? Can why you, you date keep, someone who's older than
why,
you are?
Why do you keep?
I could, yeah.
You could.
Yeah. Before we go, you have to kick you off.
Yeah. Yeah. Like you gotta, you know.
Gotta kick like, you like that.
Just like that.
Like
yeah,
that.
Just like that, man.
Just gonna stand up and.
Yeah, just gonna fly.
Just gonna stand up and walk away,
no.
Man.
Yeah. I will just use your brain and I will like.
Yeah, we have to. We have to tap your brains and all. You know, take from the financial angle. Well, thank you very much for coming through.
I'm gonna leave my number though. Just
you're gonna leave your number.
Yeah, you have to.
Yeah, cause her cookie is done. Thanks.
Excuse me.
Did you just say that?
This is the core.
All right, guys, welcome back. It's still the core, and I'm Dakel.
And I'm that famous.
Yeah, I'm talking about the guests we had here today. Yeah, I'm glad I got knowledge about the fact that, you know, investment banks, the regular banks are totally different things.
Yeah, and investment banking is definitely something that we should key into when we get bigger. But
yeah, I'm glad I got knowledge about the fact that, you know, investment banks, the regular banks are totally different things.
Yeah, and investment banking is definitely something that we should key into when we get bigger, but
yeah,
the little investments that we can do now, let's just do it. Futuristic purposes may not
helps.
Be now, but
it helps.
Definitely would help.
And I suppose I was thinking I could just invest in valuables and all that, or jewelries and all
that.
But right now,
reality check,
you
ain't know that working.
So knowledge is priceless. Knowledge is bliss. You got to learn what you have to learn.
Keep learning every day.
Never
the day
stop
you
learning.
Stop learning, you are.
You know the rest,
yeah,
guys.
You
know the rest. All right, so guys. So it's fun. It's been fun. And to watch more of this episode, more episodes, just log on to
www.delaruelive.com. Also subscribe to our YouTube channel at DelarueLive to watch
definitely.
All our programs listed there for you guys. And you can also follow me on my social media platforms at Ayefe Balogun on Instagram, same on Facebook, and at Ayefe Balogun 11 on Twitter.
Yep.
And the boring Snapchat.
All right, guys, just follow me up on Twitter at DakielUsh12 on Twitter and on Instagram, Dakiel_Ush, and we are good to go.
Yeah, definitely.
All right, guys, so it's bye for now from me.
Yeah, and from Faye, it's bye, and y'all have a fantastic, fabulous day.
This is The Core.